Attorneys need to know how to allocate costs after the fact. Attorneys have unique challenges regarding allocating costs. Sometimes you don't know which client the check or the bill is for until long after you pay. For example, March 25th, we wrote a check to Staples, and Staples gave us a box of supplies with a specific packing slip number on the top of the box. On March 25th, we don't know which client we'll use the supplies for, but we know that during the month of April, we will be using them for a particular client, and we have to allocate the cost to that client. Same thing with the March 28th check to the U.S. Post Office for $200 for postage. The stamps came in an envelope with a specific receipt number on March 28th. But we will use these stamps for a particular client during April, but we don't yet know who it is. So what do we do? Well, if you don't know what client they will be used for yet, then on March 25th and on March 28th, write the checks normally. Write the checks normally, and then on the day you use it, you do a specific procedure. So just to prepare for that procedure, let's record these two checks. They should be very easy and should only take a second. Check number three, it's March 25th of 2017, don't forget. And the first check was to Staples. I believe it was for $300 worth of supplies. Now it was for $300 worth of supplies, but in this case, the packing slip number on the top of the box is 6161. And if you have to allocate costs after the fact, it is very important that you use the memo field and you put some kind of identification on the physical item that you will use in the future. The rest is easy. Obviously, the account is supplies expense. And when we click Save and Close for this check, the general supplies expense and the trial balance will increase, even though it has not yet been allocated to a specific client. Okay, that's also true for the March 28th check to the Post Office for $200. Same thing. We open the check window and we record March 28th. QuickBooks knows this is check number four. We know the check is to the U.S. Post Office. It's for $200. And we know it's for postage expense. However, in this case, because we don't know yet which clients the check is for, we have to put in the memo field, okay, receipt number 1717, okay, to be used in the future. So it's very important if you're allocating costs after the fact that you put some identification about the physical item, some physical identification that's physically on or near the item in the memo field. Click Save and Close. And of course, postage expense increased in the trial balance. It showed up for the first time in the trial balance. But we don't know yet which client will use the postage or the supplies. Now let's imagine on April 5th, we used $50 of the supplies purchased on March 25th that had the packing slip 6161 for the Betty Boop client case. And let's also imagine on April 7th, we used $25 of the stamps purchased on March 28th with receipt number 1717 in the envelope. And that was used specifically for the Candy Charles client case. All you have to do is reopen the original transaction, in this case we're both checks, and reallocate the cost. So let's do that for the April 5th $50 for Betty Boop. It's very easy to find the previous transactions. And if you watch the supplemental videos with the tools on how to find things, it will be very easy. The easiest way to find every bank account transaction and every check is to open the trial balance and look here where it says Chase Bank Account. This is only one of several ways to find the checks. Double-click the balance and you get every check, every payment, every deposit that you recorded against the bank account or to the bank account. Now, if we make the memo field a little wider, you can see clearly this is the one from Staples with the supplies that you used. Double-click. Now, we have to allocate this, so we're going to make this $50 less. And we're going to put the other $50 on the next line. The next $50, of course, it's still supplies expense, but the other $50 is specifically for the Betty Boop job. We're not yet showing you how to bill. So let's remove the check mark that comes automatically. Yes, that was for the Betty Boop job. Okay, now of course we have another memo field here, and you can put who used the supplies, and you can put how the supplies were used, etc. But you know for sure that these supplies were used for the Betty Boop job, and of course you can put the date that it was used. Do not change the date of the check. The date of the check is the day that you paid. You're only going to put in the memo field on the line of the particular job the information and specifically when it was used. When we click Save and Close and click Yes, you'll notice that nothing in the trial balance changed. But when we look at the profit and loss by client, you can see that Betty Boop now has $50 of supplies expense. And we can double click. And we can see the check by double-clicking again, and you can come down here and see April 7th, it was used for Betty Boop. Now let's record the April 7th usage of the $25 of stamps that was purchased on March 28th with receipt number 1717 still in the envelope of stamps. And remember, this $25 of stamps was used for Candy Charles' client case. You do the exact same thing. You use one of several methods to find that particular check. Now again, if you make the memo field a little bit wider, you can see that this was the check to the post office for stamps with receipt number 1717. If you open it up, you have to decrease, not up here, decrease down here by $25. Then QuickBooks will automatically put the $25 on the next row. You know for sure it's postage expense, but in this case you know for sure that this is for the Candy Charles client job. And again, only the video that follows this one will talk about billable. So we remove the billable check mark. Now we click into the memo field and we type in used on April 7th, receipt number 1717, so that we know for sure which, we know for sure that the stamps that were used on April 7th were from the March 28th purchase, and they get allocated specifically to the Candy Charles job. Click Save and Close and click Yes. And now notice the trial balance doesn't change at all because you still have the same overall amount of postage that you paid. But when you look at the profit and loss by client under the Candy Charles job, there's now postage expense of $25, decreasing your profit from the Candy Charles client case.